Everybody, I just kind of wanted to, I don't know, try something different, and I figured I'd start with kind of throwing my hat into the ring, if you say, about how I personally feel with the new, this thing that absolutely everybody is losing their minds over. And I understand why. Now, I'm gonna get into why I specifically both think it was a good idea and why I think it was executed badly. So, obviously, we talk about loot incentive and, things like that. So, people want to do this. Well, want to do this because you have things like the Felwinters lie, you're chasing after this specific weapon that is so good and so amazing, that has slide shot and opening shot and quick draw and vorpal weapon, I think. And you could choose between them, and it's gonna be the best shotgun PvP's ever seen. It's gonna have a kill range that's better than Chaperone or whatever. And obviously that's a great reason to have people do this. Now, let me get into why I think this was a good idea. When you get right down to it, one of the main reasons Felwinters was brought back into the game was because people wanted a sort of a pinnacle ritual legendary shotgun that they didn't have to really pray to RNG to deliver the goods to them. It was just something that you could pursue, you could get it done, you had a guaranteed really good shotgun that would roll. You didn't have to spend 60 hours farming for a mind benders, and the best thing you get is a quick draw threat detector mind benders with not a range masterwork. You didn't have to have that happen. You could go into this and you could get your weapon, you could have a good shotgun, you could use it. That was one of the main reasons it was brought back. Also, you have the nostalgia factor, which is obviously a big thing for us players who played in D1. And really, really love this weapon. So, with it being sort of this thing to balance out the whole shotgun community into one shotgun, I can understand why it's a community event. If the shotgun is for the community as a whole to use, the community as a whole should have some sort of aspect in getting it. Which is why I think it was a good idea to have this quest be somewhat community-based. You have the community going after it. Now, here's why I think it was executed poorly. 9 million Seraph Tower public events is a lot of it's not public events because you have players, but even with, say, you have the max 9 people in one area, that is still a million. And that is a lot. So this is kind of where the problem arises. It's a good idea, but it's too much. Because as all of us Destiny players know, we like things that take maybe a little bit of time, maybe a little bit of effort, but we don't want things that feel like they're time gated, that feel like they're really boring. If this was minimized to 1 million, per EDZ, you have EDZ, Moon, and Isle, 1 million per each, 3 million total. People would be all over this. We would get this done in a day. We would get this done in a day. I can almost guarantee it. The problem is, it's 9 million, and there's no other reason to go for it because people are just going to get it over time, anyways. You could sit back and not do anything until it's finished and then get part of the reward. Or you could work your butt off and literally do hundreds of Seraph Tower events a day. I don't know why you would do that unless you're insane. But you could, and you would have the same reward. I feel like if Bungie was gonna go this big, they needed a specific reward to chase. Something like, I don't know, a legendary ornament for the weapon. If you did a certain amount of Seraph Tower events during this event, if you had something to really go after, this right here would change phenomenally for the better. If there was something that people who grinded a lot for could chase and get that wasn't garbage, people would be all over this. One of the we already know from data miners that there's a skin for this for the Felwinter's Lie in the database. I would not be against having that skin, or maybe just a Rasputin skin where you got like, I don't know, the pump's got Rasputin or Siva all over it. I don't know. I'm not a freaking weapons designer. You could have maybe a Siva theme, just a skin for the weapon that you can get if you did, I don't know, maybe 100 Seraph Tower public events in a fire team of three during this whole thing going down. That would be something that would get this done faster because people would want to chase it. People like to chase specific things. You can't just put an event out there that's going to make everybody bored out of their minds and expect people to want to chase it. We've had this event now for weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks. And I guarantee you, if Bungie looked at the spreadsheet and just said, I wonder what the how many people are playing this event. Oh, it's gone down drastically. I wonder why that is. Maybe it's because we've seen it for so long, and because it's sort of repeated content. If you get right down to it, this is basically escalation meets Altars of Sorrow. That's all this is. So when you have, all of these things to do, and you're just doing it in, a repeatable piece of content that is going to get insanely boring if you're not playing with friends or listening to really good music and using a fun loadout, it's gonna suck. So what I think Bungie should do is, obviously they can't do anything about this now, and I'm not saying I do not love this idea. This idea right here is a phenomenal idea. Corridors of Time, phenomenal idea. Things that involve the community as a whole is good. Make people who play a little and play a lot feel like they're doing something to help everybody. This is important. You can't just say this doesn't deserve to be in the game. You can't say something like this just. No, you just skip it out, get rid of it, make it to where this step doesn't exist. Just take me to Vostok or whatever. It's like, no, things that involve the community are important because when it comes down to it, Destiny is less of a game and more of a community. We play with each other, we look for groups, we do flawlesses, we do challenges. We do raids, we do activities, dungeons. We do all of this stuff Bungie makes for us because we're a community. We do it together. Some people go it alone. Some people go solo and that's their thing, but they're enjoying the content. We are community. If we can't be a community when it comes to something this big, this shotgun that is going to be the best shotgun in Destiny 2. What kind of community are we? We come together for raid races. We come together for dungeon. We come together for every single world's first out there. We came together to solve the Corridors of Time puzzle. Niobe Labs. These were all huge events. We came together for Whisper of the Worm. We came together for Outbreak Perfected. And something like this, so big, we should be able to come together. We should be able to come together and help each other out and get this weapon. But it's too demanding. This is too demanding for such little reward. The shotgun is amazing, but the gap for people that do everything and the people that do nothing is non-existent. They get the same rewards at the same time. That is where the problem lies. Too demanding, and there's no change in reward no matter what you do. If I wanted to see anything change when it comes to community events, it's that people who put in time get a little something extra. I didn't go into Corridors of Time, go into Sweatsicles chat, love that boy, you my boy, and, you know, spend two nights, literally 48 hours in a row, testing random solutions since we barely had a map put together, doing over 300 possible solutions to get the same reward as someone who slept through the whole event. I wanted to do it because I wanted to get it for the community. And I want a little something for that. Just a little something. It doesn't have to be big, Bungie. It just has to be something. And that's where I'm going to leave this topic. I think it's a good idea for the community to come together for this type of thing. But if it's going to be this demanding, you need to have a gap of people who do a lot getting something extra and people that don't do anything not getting that. And that's where I'm going to leave it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And I really do hope that you can kind of see my perspective on this and how I'm not going to be the most negative person in the world, because Bungie's not always making mistakes. Bungie makes good decisions. They really do. It's just the fact that we've been so prone to look at the bad things that we never look at the good things that Bungie's done. But that's a topic for another video. I hope you guys did enjoy. Like, comment, subscribe, any of that crap. I don't really care. I'm not even close to having any sort of subscriber count. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.